Hello friends, welcome back to another new video. In this video, I'm going to tell you how you can install MinGW and set up C or C++ environment in your Windows PC with VS Code so that you can write and run C or C++ programs without any errors. So let's get started. To write and run C or C++ programs, first we need to download these two setup, VS Code and MinGW setup. For that, I have written one article. It is not completed yet, but it will be completed till this video goes live. Here, from step 1, if you will click on the first point, it will redirect you to this VS Code download page. From here, click on Windows to start downloading VS Code for Windows. See, I clicked on it and thanks for downloading. See, the downloading has started, VS Code setup, but I already got setup file, so I won't download it. I will cancel it. And then from step 2, click here to download MinGW. If you will click on that click here button, you will be redirected to this page. From here, download the latest version of MinGW. Right now it is MinGW 18.0. And the downloading has started, but I won't download it because I already have it. So you can get direct link for these two setups directly from this article. This article will be completed till this video goes live. So don't worry about it. I will provide link in description. Now let's install these two. First, let's install VS Code. Double click on it to run it. And then click on I accept the agreement. Next. Just keep clicking on next. Next, and here make sure you check all these boxes. If you want to create desktop icon, check this one too, and then next, and then click on install. This will take some time to install, approximately 1 to 2 minutes. That's it. See, extracting files, and it is done now. 70% completed almost. Maybe now it is 70% completed. Okay, 100% completed. VS Code is successfully installed. We won't run it now. Now let's install MinGW. VS Code is installed now. Double click on this setup and then extract this in your local disk C folder. See, where is my local disk C? This PC. And then local disk C. Here, extract this MinGW folder. Extracting will take little more time, like 2 to 3 minutes, and after it is completed, it will be automatically closed. See, 99%. After the extraction of MinGW is completed, open your file explorer and then get in local disk C. Where it is local disk C, and then you will see this MinGW folder. Here, navigate to this bin folder and then copy the address for this path. Click on this address bar, Ctrl plus all, and then Ctrl plus C to copy it. Now click on this PC, show more options, and then click on properties. This will open settings. Here click on this advanced system settings. See here, click on this advanced system settings, and then click on this environment variables, and then here click on this path, and then click on edit. Now here, for me, the path is already there, so I will just remove it first, or I can simply double click on it to edit it. See, but let me remove it. Where is delete? Okay, now that I have deleted, click on this new button and then paste the path that you have copied and click on OK. Now we have successfully installed MinGW in our Windows PC, and now we won't see any errors while executing GCC command. So for that, let me open Windows terminal. So to clarify it, you can also do it. Say, open your Windows PowerShell and then type gcc, and if you will get some error like this gcc.exe fatal error no input files, that means that you have successfully installed MinGW. You can also check your gcc version using this command gcc dash dash version. Right now it is 11.2.0. so now that we have installed MinGW, we have installed VS Code. Now let me open a simple C program in VS Code so that we can run and compile it. It is in this directory, popc. This is hello.c, a simple C program. And then from show more options, open with code, and this will open VS Code in this directory. See, this is our VS Code. But before writing any C code in VS Code, I will recommend you to install this extension. Click on extensions and then search for C++ extension. C++ extension, C or C++ extension, say this one, and then install it. This C or C++ IntelliSense extension will help you in writing your code faster. Click on install and then it will be installed. Say installing. It will take some time and this is installed now. This will help you in writing C or C++ code faster. It is downloading some extra files for this extension. Now this is our simple hello.c program that prints hello world in terminal. To run this program, all you have to do is to get in your terminal and then see gcc is working. And if I will do lsc, I can see that hello.c in this directory. So to compile it, first type gcc and then the file name, that is hello.c. And after that you will see a new file named a.exe or anything with .exe extension. You can see it in your file section, or if you will do ls, you can see it here to see this a.exe. Now to run this a.exe, simply type dot slash and then the file name, that is a.exe, and then we see hello world in our terminal. See, it's simple. This is how you can compile and run C or C++ programs in Windows. Now let me show you one more time so that you can better understand it. See, there is our hello.c file. Now to compile it, first type gcc hello.c and then we will get one .exe file. Now to run it, just type dot slash and the file name, that is a.exe, and then we see hello world. So simple. So this is how you can install and run C or C++ programs in your Windows PC with the help of MinGW and VS Code. That's it for this video. I hope you have found this video useful. If yes, then don't forget to like this video and subscribe to me for more videos like this. I will see you in next one.